This conference will now be recorded.
Am I audible? Hi, good morning. Hello.
हेलो या किशोर सर।
या रितेश।
हेलो।
या आई एम एबल टू हियर यू।
ओके ओके राजा गोपाल इट्स जॉइन। ओके तो
ओके
कैन वी स्टार्ट विद इन 5 मिनट्स। ओके
या ओके 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 नहीं
गर्मी लग रही है आपको। नहीं लग रही है,
नहीं लग रही है
भाई यार, तो
यार शैल वी स्टार्ट।
अरे तो ये तो
यस सर
यार ओके सो विल स्टार्ट। So I'll just briefly give an introduction of Stack, sir, right? Okay, Stack, right? So Stack is nothing but the structural analysis and computation software. Okay, so as the name suggests, so the SAC is used for the structural analysis and the structural analysis and design of the structures, right? So the functionality of SAC is mainly used for offshore, right? Also it can be used for onshore structures and any normal structures, RCC structures, right? It has been used by naval architects for ship structures. Okay, so it can have some hydrodynamic features for stability analysis, right? Stability analysis for the ships, right? So the sorry, hello, thank you. Okay, shall we continue or? Hello. So as I said, so this is the thing. So majorly it is used for the offshore structures, right? So okay. So in offshore structure, so the SAC software is useful throughout the life cycle of the structure. Okay. So the it has a various features, so it enables us to use the do the analysis from the starting stage till the decommissioning stage. Okay, so once okay, it can be used for the prediction of the platform, either fixed platform or topside. Or topside. Or any floating structure, so for any kind of structure, so it can predict the behavior of the structure and do the comprehensive analysis. It can do a various analysis such as starting from the static analysis. It can perform dynamic analysis. We can do file soil interaction analysis. Okay, it can do more advanced analysis such as fatigue analysis, and it can do some more advanced like collapse. So yeah. So I hope you should be aware of StatPro, right? So the basic the background solver all of the SACs is similar. It works in same concept as StatPro only, right? Based on stiffness method, it will do the analysis. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, please continue.
No.
Yes, yeah, definitely.
Okay, okay. Right. So I think you would have used Chat Pro, right? So the SACT is more similar to Chat Pro. It's on the solver, right? So the additional features, there are more additional features into SACT, right? Which are not available in the Chat Pro, right? I will list some of those functions. Right, so some of the function are the primary and main important, most important thing is the wave loads, wave loads and environment loads. Okay, so it has more hydrodynamic features. So the SACT solver has it apart from solving the structural equations. So it can also solve the hydrodynamics. Okay, so it can do the hydrodynamics, but not very advanced hydrodynamics, like a simple hydrodynamic problem it can solve, right? Okay, so that is that one of the most primary function of the SACT, which enables to use us for the offshore structures. Okay, so apart from this one, it also can do pile soil interaction. Right, are you aware of pile soil interaction? So pile soil interaction is a non-linear problem. Okay, so what it can do is you have a jacket and you have a pile. So the soil behavior will be considered like a spring, right? It will be considered as a non-linear spring. Okay, and it will do an iteration. So it will keep on doing, repeating the analysis till the forces and the deflection are converged at the pile head, right? Which will give the more realistic behavior of the structure. So this is a pile soil interaction, and also it can do fatigue analysis. Why is fatigue analysis required here? Right. So fatigue analysis is required in the offshore because it is subjected to cyclical loads. Okay, so it is subjected to cyclical loads. The wave load causes the repetitive loading, which is cyclical in nature. So because of the cyclic in nature, the structure is subjected to fatigue loads, and the structure, in order to be integrated, in order to check the structural integrity, it is very necessary that the structure should be safe for the fatigue also, right? So that's why the fatigue is required. So understanding that the SACT software includes the fatigue analysis. So there are different types of fatigue, like deterministic fatigue. Okay, like spectral fatigue. The deterministic fatigue is mostly used in industry. Spectral fatigue is like for research purposes, right? So like that we have the fatigue analysis. Also it can do seismic analysis. Okay, the thing is in the Chat Pro, what you do? Are you able to see my screen? Right. In Chat Pro, how you do for the seismic analysis, you estimate the forces, you give the beam column Joseph, you lump the masses, and then give the forces, right? So here we need not do that. So here it is some more automated. The seismic analysis is more automated. it can do both the response spectrum method. As well as it can do time history. Also, it can do more advanced like dropped object study. Okay, dropped object study. So when you are expecting an object to drop, so that will cause an impulse force on the structure. So we need to check the structure for that impulse force. That impulse force can be studied here, right? Like a drop job that we have ship impact. Okay, right. Ship impact means the structure can be subjected to damage from the ship, right? That will cause a ship impact theory, ship impact, right? So these things, drop job, that ship impact. So these are the more commonly used functions for the stacks. Right. In addition to it, it also has some additional features like code check, code check based on different codes, various codes. We can do joint analysis, joint can analysis. Okay, joint can analysis is for the tubular to tubular joint checks. Okay, so in addition to that, it can take off BOM or MTO. Okay, MTO can be taken, right? Pile capacity can be arrived. Okay. Both the geotechnical capacity as well as the structural capacity. Right. So these are the some features, right? So now I will go into the course content of our course. So course content is we will start with the basic introduction to offshore structures. I'm not sure what you are from what background, right? If you are new to the offshore structure, then you need to know the what are all the different types of offshore structure, what are all the functions, right? And what are all the different types of structures, how to analyze each type of structure, right? So in order to know that, we have the introduction to offshore structure, right? Then one class we will see on the what are in detail, what are all the program capability of SACS, right? What, like what we have seen today. Okay, and then we'll go into the modeling. So modeling in the SACS, right? There's a more graphical user modeler called Precede. Okay, so using that Precede only, maybe I'll just show you. So this is a SACS window. Okay, so just opening. Okay, so this is a simple, so this is a modeler, right? Maybe I can. So this is a model, in this only we will do the modeling, right? So that we will see in detail of how to do the SACS modeling. Show you a jacket analysis. So this is like a simple jacket, right? So this jacket, when it is being transported, how it will be? Okay. A more complicated jacket at the top side, I will show you. So this is like a more complicated jacket at the top side, right? So these all we will check in the software, right? So if the program has such a capability that it can do any type of complex structure, okay? So on the main advantage is it can do the analysis in a very quick time, okay? If you are doing some pile size interaction like a non-linear analysis, it may take maximum one hour, right? Or if doing a normal static analysis, it will take less than 10 to 15 minutes. Right, the same thing if you are going to do in a finite element software, which may take a number of days to get completed, right? So that, okay, so this is on the modeling part. So we'll see how to model a joint, how to provide the fixity for the model, okay, and how to do the joint design, how to do the give the member offsets, okay, and then how to give the member release, how to define the member properties, right? So we can also give some special type of members, like some members can take only tension, some members will take only compression, right? So like that also we can do, okay? And then we'll go into the loading part, how to apply the loading to the model, how to apply the joint load, member loads, right? And this one would be inertia loading, right? So inertia loading may not be available most of the structural analysis software, but here we are having. So what we can do, we can give her this thing and we can give an acceleration for that one. So this feature may be useful for doing some vibration, that foundation analysis for the machine foundation. For those things also, these inertia loads will be useful, okay? So when some members are subjected to inertia loading, right? So acceleration from either direction, okay? Then how to apply the load for the members and areas, okay? And then how to simulate the non-model load. Non-model loads are some structure loads. The structure need not be modeled because the structure is not going to contribute to the stiffness of the structure, okay? But the weight has to be included in the analysis. So that is the non-model load, okay? And then comes the main important, most important part, okay? Specialty of this axle, environmental loading, right? Environmental loading, there are various environmental loading which can be applied here. Most important are wind area loading, right? We can just give the area definition for the wind and just tell what is the intensity of the wind that is going to happen in that region, okay? So it is more automated when compared to the StatPro. And wave loading. So we will see what are all the different types of wave. There are different wave theories like Airy theory, stream function, right? Sinusoidal, okay. Like that, so many wave theories are there, okay. So based on that wave theory, we will see the preliminary concept of the wave theories, and then we'll go into the wave loading. How to apply the wave loading for the sacks, inside the sacks. How to give the marine growth. Marine growth are the formation of the algae. So when the structure is in offshore, no? So there will be like marine growth formation around the structure, which will cause some additional loading. So that loading also we can give here. Okay. So then into the analysis part. So what are all the analysis options? Okay. What all codes we can check? Okay. How to give the hydrostatic collapse check. Since it is in water, no, the sub members will be subjected to hydrostatic pressure. Even my structure should withstand that also. So that is there in the hydrostatic collapse check. Okay. And then code check. So mostly, most of the international code which are applicable for offshore can be used here, right? So preliminarily ASC for steel structure, top sides, okay, API American Petroleum Institute code. So you can also do Canadian code, you can do the DNV, right, Euro code, International Standard Organization, ISO code, right, NARSOC, like that various code it can do. And then post processing, then we will go into the post processing. We will just see how to extract the results for the reporting purpose, how to view the deflection, how to animate the deflection. So those things can be seen in this, covered in this post processing. Then we'll go one by one in the analysis part. So one class for joint can analysis. Joint can analysis, the tubular to tubular joint. Okay, punching shear check. And then we'll one class we'll see the pile soil interaction. This pile soil interaction will be more interesting one. So it is a non-linear analysis. Will be more interesting. So more many other software don't have this feature. Only some geotechnical software like L-Pile or Plaxis has this feature. So in structural software, if you are comparing, no, none of the structural software has this feature of the pile side interaction. Okay, then we'll go into pre-service analysis. So like I said, so this SAC software can do cover the entire life cycle of the any jacket or top side. From the starting of the fabrication till the decommissioning, all stages can be done. So like a loadout analysis. Loadout analysis is that from the yard when it is being transported to the barge, that is the loadout. Then lift analysis, when you are going to lift the structure, how will be the behavior of the structure, that we can study. And then transportation analysis, when the structure is being transported in the sea, it will be subjected to inertia forces, right? And we'll have to design the sea fastening for that. That will be covered in the transportation analysis. Then launching analysis. Launching analysis is that the structure will be installed in the offshore by the way of launching and flotation and upending. So those two will be covered. Then while the structure is in being in service, so this pile side interaction we will have to check. Fatigue analysis we will have to check for the life cycle of that one. And seismic analysis we will have to check. So all the major analysis has been covered in this course. Right? Is it clear, Rajagopal? Any doubts? Any queries, any specific information, if I'm missing any specific information? Yeah. Do anyone else any queries or any? Okay, if it is fine, then can we close it here, Ritesh?
Hello.
Rajagopal, are you getting my voice? Do you have any doubt? Please ask to trainer. We are waiting for your response actually. Okay, Krishnan sir. Krishnan sir.
Yeah. Hello.
Okay. Can we I think he's not getting our voice.
Okay.
We will touch in conference call. Okay with him.
Okay.
Now you shall be okay, sir. Okay. Now you close to your side.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.